What we'd like to represent is that the cost of congestion increases in a quadratic-like manner as the loads on the links continue to increase, ultimately becoming increasingly expensive as link utilization approaches 1. Solving the optimization problem, however, is much easier if we use a piecewise linear cost function. We can define utilization as the amount of traffic on the link divided by the capacity. And our objective might be to minimize the sum of this piecewise linear cost function over all the links in the network. Unfortunately, solving this optimization is still NP-complete, which means that there's no efficient algorithm to find the optimal setting of link weights, even for simple objective functions. The implications of this are that we have to resort to searching through a large set of combinations of link weight settings to ultimately find a good setting. So clearly, searching through all the link weights is suboptimal, but the graphs turn out to be small enough in practice such that this approach is still reasonably effective. In practice, we also have other operational realities to worry about. For example, minimizing the number of changes to the network. Often, changing just one or two link weights is enough to achieve a good traffic load balance solution. Whatever solution we come up with must be resistant to failure, and it should be robust to measurement noise. We also want to limit the frequency of changes that we make to the network. This completes our overview of intra-domain routing, and now we will take a look at inter-domain routing. Intra-domain routing and traffic engineering concerns traffic flow within a single domain, such as an ISP, a campus network, or a data center. In contrast, inter-domain routing and inter-domain traffic engineering concerns routing that occurs between domains, something that we looked at before in the context of the Border Gateway Protocol.